Hey everybody, Susan Mershon here, the Techie Mentor. Just a big thank you for listening to this podcast, the Virtual Assistant Tips, Tricks, and Advice channel, where I share all things virtual assistant every week with no fluff, just the stuff that gets results. Hello, my friends, and welcome to this week's episode. Today, I want to talk to you really about a combination of things. It's really around onboarding new clients, and one specific part of that, which I call kickoff calls. So kickoff calls are part of your overall onboarding, as I said, and it's really part of your sales system. This is what happens after you sell a product or a service to a new client. You want to kick off the relationship, and that's what a kickoff call does. So this is after, you know, they've paid the invoice, they've signed the documents, and they're ready to get started. This is a great way to start building trust and kicking the relationship off on the right foot. It also helps you stand out as a professional because so many virtual assistants don't do these. Now, I brought kickoff calls from my years of being a project manager. And what we do in project management is whenever we have a new project, we do a kickoff call with all the team to talk about what we're working on. So it's the same concept because you're going to be working with these clients, hopefully long term, and you want to start off on the right foot. You want to start that relationship and start building that trust factor. And so this is how they work for me. Again, once the client has gone through, you know, the onboarding process of signing the documents and, you know, paying the invoices and all of those things, one of the first things I do is I want to set up the kickoff call. And we set this up. It's a one-time call. It can be anywhere from 30 to 60 minutes. They're not charged for this. It's part of my onboarding process. And I know a question I commonly get is, you know, what if I want to bill for this? And you can certainly put it in your package or your hourly rate if you want to build it in that way. But this is part of my overall business processes. So I set up the call with them and I do a Zoom call so we can get face to face. And I have a specific agenda that I use, and I've given you a link to download an agenda if you want a sample of mine. But it's fairly simple. We start off by, you know, doing an introduction, and we really go over, you know, what happens now that they are a client. What does it look like? Where do we go from here? So just to recap, kickoff calls are used to kick off the relationship with a new client, and they're used after the clients have signed on the dotted line, paid the invoice, and maybe any other things that you have in your onboarding process. But those were the two specifics that I needed done before I scheduled the kickoff call. So I didn't schedule it until those two things are done. And they are used to build trust and to start the relationship off on the right foot. It's a huge benefit to both yourself and your customer because you can really start to get to know each other. So one of the things I do on the kickoff call is I go over my business policies document. And your business policies is one that helps you really set boundaries and explain to clients how you run your business, because you know it's your business, your choice. You get to tell them how you run your business. Remember, you train your clients how to work with you. And one of the most important things is to set appropriate boundaries with clients. And I did a podcast on this recently, so you might want to go back through my list of podcasts. There is one on VA business policies. One of the things that we're going to do on the kickoff call is highlight the really important ones. And those for me are really anything that have to do with money or time, because those are very important. So for instance, if you charge a rush fee, if somebody requests something out of your, you know, average turnaround time, what is it? How does that work? What happens when you're out of the office and can't work? Do you have a trusted partner? And what does that look like? And all of this is in your business policies document. So it's not that you're springing this on them, but you're just going to take a few minutes to make sure that they understand these things and answer any questions that, you know, you may have. So really also around communication, you know, how do you do task? How do you manage task? How do you take new tasks? All of that stuff should be discussed. So there is no gray area, and the client's like, okay, I paid you this money, now what do I do?
this answers those questions for them. So my agenda again is to go over the business policies document, hit the high points, anything that has to do with time, money, or communication, and answer any questions that they have. And then the next thing that I talk about on my kickoff call is, you know, what is it that I'm going to be doing for you? So I really want to talk about tasks and priorities. So this is where we look at what this client has hired me to do, and we set kind of a work schedule, if you will. You know, what tasks need to be done and when, what is the prioritization of these tasks and so on. So I kind of have an action plan for what I'm going to be doing, and the client also already knows what I'm going to be doing. The other thing I touch on is status meetings. Now, for me, I wouldn't take a client that wouldn't meet with me at least twice a month for 15 minutes. Status calls are imperative to stay in touch with clients and to know what's coming down the pike for them and what's going on in their life so you can adjust accordingly. Part of my kickoff call was to set up status meetings. And they were on the same day at the same time, you know, either weekly, biweekly. Those were the two options that they had. And even if it's just a quick 10, 15 minutes just to check in to make sure there's no problems, this is a great way to head off any issues, to make sure there's no miscommunications, and again, to get an idea of what's coming maybe on this client's plate that might end up on yours, so you'll be ready for it. And so we would set up those kickoff calls we would set up the status calls during the kickoff call. And then I would basically ask them if they have any questions, need any, you know, help with anything, any clarification. And that would be the end of the kickoff call. So I say 30 minutes to 60 minutes. It really depends on what you're doing. You know, I had a variety of clients that were, you know, simple blogs that I would do for somebody versus, you know, some kind of product launch, which would, there's a lot more moving parts. So it would take longer for, let's say, a project client than it would for just a client where I was doing the same type of work for them every month. And it was a shorter scope of work. There wasn't as much to go on. So maybe that would be a 30-minute call, whereas a project call might be 60 minutes because there's just so much more to cover. But that kind of gives you an idea of what the kickoff call, and that's the first real official call we have once they've become a client of mine. And like I said, we just kind of figure out where we're going to go from here, answer questions, go over some of your specifics, like your business policies, you know, get them booked in on their status calls, help them understand what those status calls are for if you get any pushback. And really, again, kick off the relationship on the right foot. So those are my kickoff calls. This is part of your sales system, which is part of your four key business systems. This is really the end of, if you will, the onboarding process. Once you've sold them, they've signed and paid, then you book the kickoff call, you hold the kickoff call. The other thing is, I failed to mention, was I actually record the kickoff call and I keep it. It's an artifact that goes into my project from this client, so at any time we can refer back to it in case they said, well, you never told me that. Remember, I'm from years of corporate America. I was a project manager, so I'm under the CYA, you know, cover your assets, so I keep everything. Not that I ever had, actually, I've only had to use that once, the recording, to remind somebody that I did tell them that, and they did acknowledge that, but for the most part, it's just for my own reference, but you can certainly keep that as well. So, kickoff calls, essential if you really want to set yourself apart from the crowd and stand out as a professional. They're a really great service that you can provide as part of onboarding a new client. So I hope you enjoyed that. Have any questions, please feel free to leave your comments. I read and answer all of them. And thanks for listening. I'll see you guys next week.